time, I'ma live up. Head down, push forward through the tough times. Cause anything worth doing is a tough
time. Cause I'ma live life for the fight, yeah, I'm here to get it. I got drive, got sight, always have a vision. I go by at night, I be in my feelings, I'ma be fine.
Hello there, this is Mischief again talking about The Last Fortress Underground, the mobile game that seems more like a console game because of the constant need to improve and work on strategy. One of the most important things to get right is gear, and you guys have requested I make this video for a while now. I constantly tell people that gear is more important than the ascension level of a hero. Think about when you are going up against someone with the same team in their lineup, same level, same skills, same statue attributes. The thing that will determine if you win is your gear and a few other factors, but let's just stick to one topic. Because this will be a long one and lots of information, I will be breaking this up into multiple videos. To get the best experience, watch them in order so you understand all of the concepts. New heroes and gear will be introduced as the game goes on. So my goal for this video is to teach you how to figure out what gear is right for each hero. I will also show you a few resources you can use to see what other people are doing if you feel lost. When it comes to gear, there are some facts and there are a lot of opinions. When I explain how gear works and how stats work, everything I say in that regard is a fact. If I list specific gear for specific heroes, know that that is just an informed opinion. There might be people out there who disagree on the gear, which is okay. That is a big reason why your choice of gear is so important. Each hero has more than one right set, and everyone has preferences. That being said, let's get started. When it comes to gear, the main thing that you need to understand is how your hero stats work. If you click on your hero, you can see some of the basic stats under the information section. And if you click each stat, it explains what each one does. But let's dive into them. The two most important stats are strength and intelligence. Let's look at the first one that is listed, which is STR for strength. The tooltip states that this increases the hero's weapon damage during battles. If you click on a hero's first skill, you can read what type of damage this hero does. When you see the acronym WPN DMG for weapon damage, you will know that this is a crucial stat for that hero. The next stat on the list is INT for intelligence. When you click on this tooltip, it states that INT increases the hero's TAC, DMG, or tactical damage during battles. This is the other stat that you will want to click on your hero's first skill to see if it states whether you do weapon damage or attack damage. If it says attack damage, then you know that INT is a critical stat for this hero. Most gear comes in strength or intelligence gear, and these are the two primary stats that you would want to look at. There are some heroes that I have seen questions on, like Quinn, whose first skill says attack damage and her third skill says weapon damage. This causes a bit of confusion. If you ever feel you are unsure, click on the portraits, find the hero, then click max level in the bottom right, then click the little explanation point in the top right, and it will show you her base stats at max level. You would want to base your gear choice on whichever stat is the highest. The next stat listed is AGI for agility. When you read the tooltip, it states that agility reduces the weapon damage and attack damage the hero takes during battles. Agility works kind of like a dodge sometimes. You kind of avoid damage. And it is excellent for tanks, but it is really a helpful stat for any hero if you want them to be harder to take down. I have seen past videos where people try to keep the tanks at the lowest in agility so that the heroes that target the lowest agility will go after the tanks. This is a useful strategy to combat Kelly and Rebecca, but not so useful against any other heroes. Kelly and Rebecca are used in most lines until season 3 or so. but you know your server better than I do. To know whether this is still an effective strategy, one way to check is to go into Arena, click on the trophy, look at what the top teams are using. If you see a bunch of Kellys and Rebecca, then this might still be a viable approach to defense. Otherwise, stacking on agility for defense is a good strategy when not focusing on the luck stat. The next stat is VIT for vitality. This increases hit points or health during battles. This is just a set number that is raised. So in my opinion, if you want to improve a hero's amount of time that they get to live by a defensive stat, I would focus on agility. Agility gives a constant dynamic benefit where vitality just adds some health to the hero that is just a single static benefit. Once the health points are gone, they're gone unless you have a healer that is still alive. But with agility, it will reduce the damage with each hit. And in the long run, that adds up to a more useful stat in my opinion. However, remember that Galland and Kayla target the hero with the lowest health, and Mira's first skill is based on her hit points. She will restore more health with more vitality stacked on her. The next stat is actually a significant strategic stat, is LUK for luck. Luck increases the initiative of a hero. The initiative is a hero's chance of using their special skills, but also the hero with the highest initiative attacks first in the battle round, and the hero with the lowest attacks last. So you can use this as a way to create a strategy on who you want to attack first and who you want to attack last. For example, in my Watcher team, I have Laurel, who has an ability called Corporate Arsenal that gives the whole team a damage bonus and a damage mitigation buff. So I want her to do her skills first to hopefully get the team doing more damage as soon as possible. So when I build statues or put gear on her, luck is something I am looking at. On the flip side, I also have Galland on my team, which has a skill called Execution. This skill only is useful if the hero kills the target. So I want him to be the last person to move, so I want to keep his luck lower than the other teammates, but not so low that he moves after my opponent. So this is part of the strategy that comes with the stat. If you cannot get your luck high enough to move before your opponent, focus more on defensive builds. These five stats are the basic stats that you can increase with statues and gear. However, many more can be found on gear, so let's look at what those do. Crit rate, or critical rate, is usually found on weapon slots of gear. This stat increases the critical hit of a hero's basic attack or skill attack. The base crit deals 130% base damage. Crit immunity rate can usually be found on a tanking gear, reducing the chance a critical attack hits a hero. Crit damage or critical damage increases the damage a critical hit deals. So the crit rate is the chance it will hit, and the crit damage is how hard it will hit. HP is hit points, or you can think of it as how much health they have. If you increase HP through the gear with this stat or through vitality, you increase the number of times a hero can be hit. When the hit points reaches zero, the hero dies. ATK or attack boosts both weapon and tactical damage by a hero. This weapon can be displayed more specifically as a weapon attack or attack, which affects the auto attack damage and improves the hero's weapon or attack damage. DEF or defense is another stat that sometimes is just DEF, or weapon defense, or attack defense. All the defense stats help decrease the damage a hero and soldier take. If it says specifically weapon or attack defense, it is only helpful against heroes that wield the skills of that type. DMG bonus or damage bonus usually appears on the accessory gear slot, or you can refer to it as the one furthest to the right. Damage bonus increases damage dealt by attacks and skills. Sometimes the skill is more specific and it says weapon or attack damage bonus, so make sure they are placed on the correct hero for the most benefit. DMG mitigation is another skill that usually appears on the accessory slot and can be shown as just damage mitigation or weapon or attack mitigation. This stat reduces the damage taken by heroes, as the name implies. Crit pierces defense is a rare stat, but it makes critical hits ignore part of the defense of the target. Focus can be found on super core gear released in Season 5, and it directly affects when the hero makes their first skill move and how often. If you click on the first move, it will tell you how much focus they need before they use that skill. Also, if you look at a team during a battle, they have a little circle that fills up during the fight next to their health bar. This fills up faster the more focus they have and increases every time that hero gets hit or attacks your opponent. And you can even start a battle with it full if your focus is high enough. This is what determines how often your team uses the first skill attack, but they will still make a basic attack when the circle is not full. Focus DMG or focus damage can be found in your season policy card, and this stat increases the damage of your hero's first ability. Shield bonus DMG increases the damage dealt to shields, so it is the counter stat to many healers and tanks. And extra healing effect improves the healing and shielding skill of a hero. One thing to keep in mind when looking at stats on gear is a percentage is always better than a set amount. For example, 5% of agility is better than plus 5 agility because it will scale with your hero and as you level. So now that you know a little bit more about what stats are for, you can use the knowledge to help you decide which gear to put on your heroes. Most of these stats are random, so even if you know you want to put a specific set on someone, let's look at Gallant for example. In my opinion, Death Gear was made for him. The most important stat is strength, since his skill causes weapon damage. But what else should I look at? One piece might have crit immunity, and one might have agility or hit points. And it is up to you to make the decision on which stat is most important to you. I purposefully picked a friend I know is very good at studying gear and what is best for each person in arena in just what I currently had on. Also note, all of my statues were spec'd into mostly strength and intellect for this exercise, and I lost. If I watched the reenactment of the fight, I noticed a few things. Kelly and his Gallant both target my Gallant first. Also, the majority of his team moved first. This is because in comparing stats, most of his team had higher luck, so therefore, they would move first. Having higher luck isn't the only thing you need to look at. It's just how you determine who on your team goes first. So one of the stats I needed to adjust on most of my team was to get higher luck. On Gallant in particular, I needed higher agility since Kelly targets the lowest agility member. I also needed him to have higher health since Gallant targets the lowest health on the team. After I adjusted some gear and the statues, I retried against my friend and barely won. He still has higher CP than me and is close to the same team, so a strategy like this is the only way I can come out the victor in a fight against him. Some heroes target the lowest agility, lowest health, back row, front row, and many others. I would focus on studying what specific heroes seem to give you the most trouble in arena or anywhere else, and learn to counter them with the correct gear and counter stats. In the next video, I will be talking about the current sets that are out, and I will be bringing up some of the information I have discussed to explain why each set works the way they do and my thought process on gear. See you in the next video, and thank you for watching. I appreciate the support. I'm here to get it. I got